Tyler, what are we doing?
Is that a camera or a phone?
It is a camera. What does it look like?
It looks like you modified a phone.
No. My phone's in my pocket.
Okay, wait a minute. The brown dye.
No, but we have Ryan.
Oh, there he is. A little slow to the party, my friend.
Film me.
I film you. See? Look, he's a red and black OC.
Before break.
So, yeah, this is just food time.
Oh,
it's amazing. Alright, we're about ready to leave. I got all my stuff ready. Yay! They're making fun of us. Such rude. We're playing the game that I suck at the most. Are you having fun?
Yes.
I think that is a no. Badge. I think I chose a bad cider fest to start with.
Why?
All right.
Sure.
We are in the main events area. Who's ready for stupidity and craziness?
You guys aren't listening to me, how dare you?
I'm listening.
We're ready for craziness, right? You're a big head, you know.
Actors will go. The panels are filled with assortment. When you go in, you are sure to be welcomed. You can bring your kids. You can bring your friends. No pony can resist the vendor hall. There's no worry, but it's all just a clean cider.
This is how messed up I am. I think it's evening already. Good morning and welcome to Ponyville Cider Fest 2016!
Yay.
I am Charlie Worthley, Princess Rainbow Dash Fire whatever, Unicorn. One of your co-chairs?
Hi guys, I'm Corey. You guys see me here. We're magical unicorns of
Cider and friendship. Cider and friendship.
Are you guys ready for an awesome weekend?
So, I imagine some of you are here to see some of our guests of honor, correct? Well, let's bring them out up onto the stage. First up, we have, for her second con, she was just at MLP MSP a couple months ago. Please welcome Willa Milner.
Princess Ember, right?
I don't know. I don't know who these people are.
Hey, Bronies, how are we doing?
Next up. This is, so we have somebody who is her second con. We have somebody who is going to be her last My Little Pony convention. Maybe or may, you may not have heard.
Jen Boy.
I know, but we are going to make sure that we send her out with a bang, so to speak. And well, we'll see about that one.
I'm not
please welcome Jen Blake.
Contractually obligated to do this voice. I can't do Rainbow Dash. Tara took it from me. That's it. I'm done talking. Oh my God, my mom's here. Thanks, Mom.
Next up, for his third Ciderfest in a row, please welcome Princess Big Mac.
Big Mac. Don't listen to you, my Big Mac.
You like my cosplay?
Fortunately for myself and Corey, we were not the only two we managed to convince to get into these ridiculous things. Please welcome Mr. Jim Miller.
Is that Eeyore?
So happy to be here.
What is that?
And next up, Katrina Hadley.
Obscure answers to questions. All of our questions we ask to other bronies, and we give them 100 seconds to answer these questions. So
At the end of each round, the highest score shall be eliminated. So let's get on to it. Let's start our first category, and it is Conventions of North America. Conventions. So please discuss who you like to go first. And the person who's going first, please step up to that east team.
And then do we alternate?
Yeah, we'll go down the line with each of you giving an answer, and then you come back down the line with the other players.
Sure.
And here's our first question.
All right. Okay, it is any state or Canadian province that's hosted a Brawny Convention since 2011.
Yeah, so pretty straightforward here, guys. We want you to name any U.S. state or any Canadian province that has hosted a Brony Convention since 2011. By Brony Convention, of course, we mean any convention whose primary focus is My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. So no conventions that are multi-genre, so any specific Brony Convention. Best of luck.
Thank you very much. Okay, Nick. So what is this number convention for you? I'm sorry? Ryan, so is this your first convention, second convention?
I've lost count.
I've been to 18. So what would be a state where a Brony convention would be hosted? Washington State, the Evergreen States. Okay. Let's see if it's correct and see how many people said Washington. That's right. 40. So 40 people said it. And what? So not bad. So Brian, what number convention is this for you?
This is Brian.
Still
Nick.
Nick.
When I do this show, I get the name tags because I have a problem all the time. Exactly.
I should know what I'm supposed to. So Nick, what number convention is this for you?
Six.
Okay. What would be a state's or a Brony convention, or a province, Canadian province, so it's definitely Canada, which a Brony convention has been hosted.
So in Missouri.
Missouri. Okay. Let's see if this correct. See how many people said it. That's right. Now we're on 40. Well, 24. Oh. Very good.
Yeah, well done. First of all, Washington, of course, Evergreen Northwest, Missouri, Midwest Brony Fest, very, very good, very good. So good job on that.
Well, for 2017, yes, but when I was in Kansas City, Missouri, that counts. Also St. Louis Crystal Pony Fair. Okay, you're next.
All right.
Josh, what number convention is this for you?
I've been to a few conventions around the state, around MOP, MSP, this one, BronyCon, and yeah.
Okay, what would be a state or province which was that's also BronyCon?
I would say Illinois.
Illinois, or Illinois. Where's your presence of Illinois? Let's see if it's correct and see how many people said it. That's right. You say it's another like one? I say it's another like 14. So.
Yeah, good job on that, Winnie City Con, or Chicago.
Yep, but I feel like most people would think that it's Chicago rather than Illinois.
Right, same, but yeah, good job.
Okay, on the end, your name again?
Matt.
What number convention is this for you?
Third Cyberfest, lost count.
That was my third Cyberfest as well. And so, a state or a Canadian province?
I do believe there was one in Hawaii.
You say there's one in Hawaii. Let's see. If it's correct, let's see how many people said it. Oh, unlucky. That is an incorrect answer. There's never been.
Yeah, sorry, not yet. Lots of multi-family cons over there, but unfortunately no Brony specific convention.
As a result, you get a score of 100 on that. So now let's bring the second players to the chairs. And we're gonna go back down the line, so. So, on the end there, please. Once again, introduce yourself. And
I'm Sarah.
Sarah, so what number convention is this for you?
It's my first Peroni convention and my third modern convention.
Oh, very good. So, your team has 100 right now, so you need a miracle. But what Sarah Prouds would have hosted a Peroni Con since 2011?
Well, let's go north of the border
and
say Ontario.
Ontario. Or as they say at the bar, Ontario.
No.
That's curling, so let's see if it's right to see how many people said it. It's right. And it is 24.
Oh.
24, so your total is 124. You're still in this, but it's not looking good for you. But we'll see.
Yeah, good job. Yeah, of course, Ontario is Canterlot Con there.
Okay, that's
right where it's coming in 2013. And as Dan said, still in the game with that answer. So, good job.
You cannot consult at this point of the team. So, all right, team number three, your name once again.
Ace.
Ace, okay. You have 14 right now. You're already through to the next round. So, but what would be a state or Canadian province that's hosted a voting convention since 2011?
Georgia.
Georgia. Well, let's see if it's correct. See how many people said Georgia. Oh, that's an incorrect answer, unfortunately, but you're still through. Your score is 114 now, but you're still through.
Yeah, you would think, because there's a lot of big anime conventions and such there, but yeah, no voting conventions in Atlanta just yet, sorry about that. But again, there's still three conventions.
Or any state of Georgia proper, but, or former Soviet Republic, Georgia. So, yeah, you are third to the next round. Also third to the next round, team number two, your name again?
Joseph,
your total is 4 right now, so well, time to let's see if a state or province that's also voting country since 2011.
Nevada.
Nevada.
We
don't talk about that. That's why I read over. Whatever happens there, probably stay there. Let's see if it's correct. Well, we know it's right. And it is 15. So, player 19. You're already through the next round.
Yeah, rightfully said, the con that shall not be named infamously in that state. But yeah, good job on that.
Which is also my no score first two points.
That funny exponent.
But yeah, going to be the lowest score of the round between the two of you, so good job, guys.
Okay. So, Colin, you have 40 right now. And.
Yes.
You just basically you have to avoid an incorrect answer to go through. So, what number convention is this for you?
I do believe there's one in Ohio.
Ohio. Okay. So, let's see if it's correct. See if it's. How many people said it? That's right, you're through to the next round. You need 85 or more to not go through. 20. So, your total is 60. You're through to the next round. And Greg, explain which convention's in Ohio.
Yeah, there's a couple of notable ones. TrotCon is there, Camelot Gardens is there. But yeah, basically you just need to give the right answer to go through, and you did so. Good job.
Okay, let's go through all the answers for this. There was only one pointless answer here, and that was Louisiana, and that was Derby County South.
DerbyCon South is specifically a Burley Con. There is a con called DerbyCon that is in New Jersey that is a multi-fandom con. But the one in the South in Louisiana is just a Burley Con.
Wait, I thought Pennsylvania got one.
PhillyCon? This was after. I should have said this
have,
was. After,
have had.
Have had.
Philly.
This was before. As of August 13th, and PhillyCon was after that. So I should have made that clear, but.
Yeah, and going forward for all of the questions, that's the cutoff date. So
yeah.
Anything by.
Unless I say otherwise, it's August 13th.
What did Utah?
There's one in Utah, there's a lot of money now. So unfortunately, Team 4, we have to say goodbye to you. I have some wine bags for you. Let's give this guy, Team 4, a hand. Spread out a bit here. And
get to the head to head, you all actually can sit down.
Yes. So, first, let's find the category. And we're going to go away from North America and to the conventions of the world. Conventions of the world. Let's see. Decide who goes first. We're going to find out. Conventions of the world, and here we go. It's any country besides the US and Canada that has hosted a Burning Convention since 2011. Greg will show its blank.
Yep, any country besides the United States and Canada that had the Burning Convention since 2011 and before August 13, 2016, thank you. And by country, we mean sovereign states that was a member of the UN or of its own before. So, there you are. So, any country.
All right, Brian, you go first.
How about Russia?
Russia. Russia, let's see if it's correct. See how many people said Russia. It's right. 10. Very good. Oops.
It's actually 11. My fault.
But it's still very good.
Same thing happens to me all the time on my pointless, but yeah.
Yeah, well done. Russia has a Rubronikon. Rubronikon. So there you go.
So very good, it's 11, so. Okay, you're up first, you're next. It's Joseph. You just need a country, so.
Spain.
Okay, let's see if it's correct.
Miraculous or terrible.
We'll see. It is right.
Yeah.
It's 11 for Brian. How is Joseph? Eight. So very good.
Yeah, summer wrap-up festival, and I assume the song is a little different there, but yeah, I'm gonna do a good job on that.
Don't say
countries, you're giving people answers.
Okay, Josh, okay, you're up.
Okay, I'm not totally furious, but I think there is one in Germany.
Deutschland. Anyone been to Mayors or have Bratwurst yet? Seems correct. See, so it is right. 8 for us, 56, which is pretty high.
Yeah, bad luck on that one with the high score. A couple of notable ones, Gallicon is there, Brony Fair, but yeah, really high score. Hopefully, the partner will get out on this one.
Time to point.
Okay, let's bring your partners in. So, Ace, 56 is your score right now. Need something.
Sweden.
Let's see, Sweden. The team is correct. See how many people said it. Correct. Good. We have a two. These are 3 years ago, but they had one.
Yeah, Trahom, it was called. Trahom, so good job there. Hopefully that'll save you for this round. Let's see what happens.
We'll see, that brings your total of 58, so.
Nick. Still Nick.
Yeah, 8.
49 or less.
United Kingdom?
The UK. Let's see, it's correct. The only people said it. As we're gonna say, you need 49 or more will put you in trouble. 54. That gets your total 62.
Yeah, bad luck there. You put team 3 through to the head-to-head with that one. I will say the UK con that most people are aware of has the coolest name of any. It's called Buck. It was B-U-C-K, so there you are. So good job. All right, Palin.
Japan.
Okay.
You had 11. So
46 or less.
46 or less, we'll put you through the next round. Let's see if it's correct and see if anything says. Right? 46 or less puts you through. You are through. 26. Your total is 37. So, well done. So, let's go through all these.
It's got the great name of Japan Pony Con.
Yes.
But it is a con in Japan. Yep. About ponies. So there you are. Good job.
So here are the rest of one. Again, just one point was answered, and that was Argentina.
Yeah, unfortunately, we heard the two worst answers, Germany, United Kingdom, but at least no incorrect answers on this one, so good job there, guys.
Does Brazil have
one? No.
No?
Not yet.
Pretty good, yeah. So that means we have to say goodbye to Team 3. Big hand for Team 2, sorry. Team 3 stays. Yeah, it's been a long day. So, thank you, guys. Good night. I'll put it up on the last one.
So, my round 1 and round 2, yes, they're currently seated in the correct positions. Team 3 is going first off.
Okay.
Always a good one. Alright, the my scores are round 1 and round 2, they scored 81, they scored 97. So
right. Alright. You both get to see it. Sit down.
Everyone gets to sit down now.
Everyone gets to sit down now. Yeah.
You get a chair.
Everyone gets a chair.
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 Do the taxes on these chairs.
Anywho. All right. So now we're on to the head to head. And this is now best 2 out of 3, and you can consult each other for these questions. So
you are allowed to confer.
So again, the actors get the lower score. And for each question, lower score will get a point. 2 points wins, the game goes on to the final. So, let's go on with the first question. It's about Nightmare Nights. Okay, we're gonna give you six costumes here, and Greg will go run them down for you.
Yeah, so as you can see, we're showing you six costumes that were worn by a pony in the first episode of Future's Nightmare Night, Lunar Eclipse. We want you to tell us which pony wore the costume. Of course, go for the most obscure one, and you will stand the best chance of winning this. Best of luck.
So we have Reggie and a scarecrow, a dragon, a clown, a wolf, and a chicken. So, our team goes first. So, which one would you want? And you gotta guess the pony who wore it.
Oh, it's fine. Yeah, you guys go first.
You go first. You have the lowest score.
Which one?
Okay, we're gonna say that the one who wore the clown suit is Mayor Mare.
Okay, and now Colin and Brian, you get to choose one. And the pony who wore it.
You go through the whole board if you want, just decide which one you want to be the one
that's cool. Yeah, I got the lowest.
Lower, with your answer, then they score.
But, the pilot
dragon.
And as weird as it sounds, Spike.
Dragon and Spike?
Yeah.
Okay, let's start with the clown. You said it was near and near, let's see. Right. And 60. Maybe not a square, maybe not be. Let's see. Dragon, Spike. Said. Let's see. Spike is a dragon. Best dragon. So if our team gets a point, so let's run through these.
All right, audience, you get to play along on this. Who was Raggedy Ann?
This is Kate.
Yeah,
yeah, that was the most obscure.
Yeah, that would have scored you 24 points on that one. How about the Scarecrow?
Andrew.
Yeah, Jack, good job. He's still 64. Who was the wolf?
Skirtaloo.
Yes. There you go. And finally,
it was the second.
You think that the screw should have been the chicken on this one, but it was Pinkie Pie at 73. So there you go. Good job, guys. This is taken. That goes on the board, so good job. All right. Nightmare Night continues. Swift. And close your eyes.
Okay. No spoilers!
Okay.
There we go.
Nightmare Night Part 2. And we'll show.
And again, here are six more. This time we're going to the second Nightmare Night episode for Scare Master. Six more costumes. Again, we want you to name the pony that wore these costumes. And again, the most obscure wins the point. Best of luck.
Okay, so we got a gladiator, a roller dancer, a platypus, a mermaid, a bat, and a wonder bolt. So. Who goes first, Colin and Brian?
They go first.
You can use that microphone. Either one can answer.
Roller dancer, Pinky.
Okay, and.
Okay, mermaid is Verity.
Mermaid is Verity. Let's start with the roller dancer. You said it was Pinkie Pie. Let's see. That's right. 54. So 54. If mermaid's lower than 50, Verity is lower than 54, you win the point, you win the game. You're going to the final. Let's see. Verity for the mermaid. She is the mermaid. Is it less than 54? That close. Stay here for a moment. Colin, Brian, so congratulations. You are through to the next one. Let's go through these. Obviously, you won't answer from me. So.
All right, audience, let's start with who was the bat, first of all. Fluttershy, of course, was the bat. What about the gladiator? Sparkle, yeah, good job. We scored you 37. How about the Wonderbolt?
Scootaloo.
Scootaloo, yeah, 32. And finally, the platypus. Appleworm, yeah, they scored 29. Best answer on the board. Good job, everybody in the audience.
So, Kyle and Brian, thank you for playing. You get flying bags, so I'll give those out to you.
I learned how to take a break from a con.
Okay, so I'm in the game room right now, but so, goddamn, what was the name of the game? Oh, we just got back from the pony face-off panel, and I won. Just barely, but I won. And apparently I was the first person in a while to win every single face-off that happened, because I guess if you land in a trap, a face-off happens. So, I feel pretty accomplished right now. I don't know what my prize is yet, but I will soon. And I bet it's going to be pretty sweet. I'll see you with something else. Probably with karaoke.
Yeah, that was great.
instrumental or vocal? Instrumental.
Instrumental. Okay.
Ready? Ready?
Yeah. Yeah.
You want the duet instrumental, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. 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 Check it out.
Well then.
What is good, amigos? Cartoons here, except for I'm not actually cartoons. I'm just a stupid cosplayer. I'm waiting for Hooters line. Hopefully Garnico oversleeps again so I can replace him. Okay, so we've had one person think that I'm actually Toon Critic, and there's actually a staff of the convention. So that's actually quite shocking. But yeah, right now I'm just waiting for the cosplay meetup. I've decided to only record panels that aren't being recorded by someone else, to my knowledge. Like, Who's Line, I'm probably not going to record those anymore because, I mean, there's just no reason to. At least not for me. Like, majority of AC Race Fest panels, I guess I should say, and a few others. Pony Face Off. Oh, interesting story about that, actually. So, Pony Face Off. And those for you who are there at the panel, you already know what happened. And the video will be uploaded by Grego's Game Show soon, but I won. Cartoons didn't win, I won. But yeah, it was a close one, and I won a free badge to Windy City, so I am guaranteed going there. So yeah, I'll end this video now because people are crowding to save it.
I'm
sorry, that was totally my fault, by the way.
I should do that with my first year.
The power cord.
But then again,
did you need more cord? We can. This is okay. We can take a moment and. There you go.
Plus, all your pretty much.
And you can move more than like 2 feet.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah, I don't know the other.
First sitting actually seems like a bad idea. First sitting.
It's number two.
Because I'd rather not die heat. Have to rely on a battery just to stay alive.
Not all. Cloudy skies is main.
Here we go.
Show is like the only thing you know. You talk about it every day. You know this is child's play. Is learned all the children are the hurt. You know the show for younger crowds. How can you say you're proud? Nothing in front of you. Everything and everything. You said your precious mind. Now you're walking up my mind. And then you had the nerve to ask me to observe. Girls, let them sail on for twilight.
take my hit and it'll happen to you.
Don't you escape, yeah. I see a future blowing through. I see days if I'm not free. I see a future caused by you. I see a path not meant to be. The future should be filled with magic, dreams and wishes brought to life. But the things ahead are dark and tragic. No time for hope when all is dry. Whatever might have been, all the dreams that slowly share, because of you so well brought. Now the future is a cold nightmare.
Thank you. don't trust all of him.
Taking back the throne. This car, we won't take it anymore.
top anymore.
Afternoon.
Hello guys, I am your Brony Wolf Attacker Guy. I know I'm not wearing my normal stuff, but I just thought wearing cartoons hoodie would be enough. Hopefully he doesn't kill me for it. Now, I'm not really going to have a lot of screen time here. I was on stage earlier on the Ponyville Derby. Everyone thought I was Baldwin's though, because I'm not wearing my normal stuff, and I'm not in complete cartoons. So, yeah. I'm not even going to be here all today. So, I just wanted to let you guys know that I still exist. And with that said, this is a wrap for Ciderfest. Most likely. I don't believe this is the end of the vlog, though. I might do some stuff in Illinois. So, stay tuned for that. That'll be with Baldwin's, though. I will just go now. I will see you in some more awesome videos next time I do one. Well, I made it to this factory.